Rather learning Hyperion, the tool will discuss about how Hyperion is implemented, what are the prerequisites, how do we proceed step by step. I'll be also talking about at every point about how do you design your solution based on your client requirement, your customer needs, and you maintain your queue performance always higher. And the core part of any solution in business intelligence, if your solution is not fast enough and doesn't meet the business needs, the solution people do not like it. So performance and user need is not something we address at the end of the day. We address right from the first day we start building the solution, right? So let's start understanding what is the need. So for example, my client has given me some reporting requirement. Let me open two kind of requirement for you. There's one requirement, a basic requirement, and one we have taken from the So we'll discuss about what is dimension modeling today. The topic which we are going to discuss about the architecture, the characteristics, why do we need this, how the relational database is different than multi-dimensional database, and the difference between both of them. In terms of user view, in terms of technology, in terms of cost and implementation timelines, all four important areas will be touch base. So we are going to start with the first topic called dimension, facts, various operation on dimension and factables. Let's understand what is facts and dimension. Okay, before we understand, let's look at what is the requirement. How do we get all these things? Okay, so there are a couple of requirements submitted by my client. You can see there's a data model. When I see data model, it's a graphical presentation of your tables. In relational database, we call this ER model, entity relationship model. In data warehousing, we call it dimension model because we have a dimension and fact tables. In a demo session, I walked you through about what is dimension. If you remember, when you present data to the business, we organize the data in terms of dimension and facts. Now look at in this example is a two-dimensional view to your data. Your traditional RDBMS organize the information in a tabular manner. This is how your traditional database organize the data. Now if you look at this data, we call term called records, right? One row is one record or one transaction. Therefore, we call it transactional processing system. In simple word, if you go to Walmart and buy some product, pay money and come back, the whole process is one transaction. How system will interpret this? You go to some shop, Walmart, buy something. In which country, which city the shop is located, what product you bought, the product category, various information about the product, which day the transaction happened, what was the store name, who was the store manager, the type of store, how much quantity of product you bought it, what is the operational cost associated with the products, and all the information, and what kind of transaction happened. So one row is one transaction. Your traditional data warehousing, so a traditional database speaks in terms of transaction. Your salary processing, order processing, these are the example of transaction. But in the dimension modeling, data warehousing, we do not talk about in terms of transaction. We talk about in terms of analytical questions. For example, if you look at this model or look at any report, there are two things we identify: dimension and facts. What is dimension? A view, a prospect towards your data. So in this example, two-dimensional view, one dimension is called time, another dimension is called province or cities, and this is the data. Data is any number or a fact. Any numeric value is the data which satisfy certain rules. What are these rules? We'll see subsequently. So if you look at this, the two-dimensional view of the data, when you compare two cell, it has got certain business meaning, right? How do you read this? This says the total sales for quarter one for New York. So you read the data with the intersection of dimension, the total sales of quarter one and New York. This is how you read. Similarly, you say the total sales of quarter two and New York. So if you look at it from business front, what is the meaning of these two sentences? It will talk about it's quarter over quarter sales growth, right? When you look from business front, this is what they mean. From one quarter to another quarter, what is the sales growth? Similarly, each intersection talk about certain thing. The total sales, when you look at this intersection, this says total sales for quarter one for all the province versus total sales for quarter two. It means the important point over here is dimension. Now this is a three-dimensional view of information. You have time, you have province and sales manager. So now if you look at this cell, this all intersection versus this all intersection, what does it say? The total sales done by John for entire year versus total sales done by sales manager Mac for the whole year for the same city. What is business meaning for this? You are performing, you are testing the sales manager performance statistics. You get calculating the sales manager performance stats. How John is performing versus Mac for current year. Right, so any intersection talk about certain business meaning. Two information we can derive from here, the dimension and fact. Again, we look over here. This is four-dimensional view. In fact, this is five-dimensional view. Time, province, sales manager, store type, and product. The same data I'm organizing. This is the data only. This is data I'm organizing rather than from transactional view to multi-dimensional view. So if you look at this data is talk about these two data cell talk about the sales done by John under online sales and direct sales. Sales done by John, where the store type was online or direct in the same province for quarter one. Sorry, it is John and Mac under online sales. So organizing data in multi-dimensional view gives you liberty and gives you high level of data analysis view. The more dimension you have, the higher degree of data analysis we can do. So permutation combination, the possible combination of analysis is 5, 20. It's basically there is an additional row, column. I delete this. The 20 column, 20, the 80. 80 cell permutation combination can be a kind of data analysis. The more dimension you have, the higher degree of analysis we can do it. When I split this into two piece, it look like this. One for John and another one for Mac. You can assume in a programming language, you can assume it's like a double dimension array. You cut this piece. This is one piece of your array. This is another piece of array. So by cutting the piece into array, one for John and Mac, what you are trying to achieve, you are trying to evaluate these two salesperson performance, right, for online source. So dimension allow you to navigate and analyze your data in a higher degree. So the first thing which we need to understand, what is dimension? It's just a navigation point. The definition: qualifying characteristics that provide additional view or prospect to the given fact. So it gives a view towards a fact. It's a dimension. and dimensions are always stored in a different table called dimension table. We use a term called dimension table and fact table. In relational database, we do not have these terms. We call them as only tables. So if you have customer table, would be split across multiple tables. Customer personal information, customer correspondence. But here we talk about one subject area. Now look at this, my data model. So what I shown you in Excel sheet, the same thing I organized in terms of data modeling. Now you see, for each subject line, there is one table, and therefore we call one dimension. One subject line for product, which has got all product information. All product information. The product information like product category, subcategory, product name, family, and various other information about the product. We kept together and store into one table, and therefore we call it one dimension. The dimension essentially have to have one primary key. Right? Fundamental concept of RDBMS, you have to have a primary key in order to uniquely identify the record. Similarly, in each dimension table, one dimension table talk about one subject area and have to have a primary key. Similarly, I have one dimension for customer, one for time, one for channel, one for promotion, and different kind of customer and countries. So when you organize this in the multi-dimensional view, you distinguish. Suppose this is my four-dimensional view. So we need one table which talk about time, one table talk about city and province, one for sales manager, one for product related. So got four tables, four dimension table, and one table which store the data. Now the question is, how do you find which is dimension, which is fact? What is your source of identifying? See, when you build a warehouse, a business intelligence reporting solution, it is more likely people have been using some reporting, some other reporting tool before you introduce BI. They may be using Excel, which is more prominent and very often, or they may be using Java, .NET, any legacy reporting system they may be using. And most often you need to overwrite or build your reporting solution on top of the legacy reporting solution. There's a high probability of this. User, your business user must be knowing what they need, right? Unless we are part of the business, we do not know what they need. The business may be knowing what they need. So we take reporting requirement from them. For example, I have some reporting requirement. I split into requirement. So my business says they always like to see top 5 customers, from which customer they are getting more revenue, so that therefore they want to reward their customer. This is my need. So the kind of reporting business always want top N, we call top N analysis, very common kind of analysis. And in this example, they need to find out top 5 customers. They want to find out top 5 customer for quarter 1, quarter 2, quarter 3, and quarter 4. And which customer is consistently top in the hierarchy. They want to reward the customer or want to give some loyalty points, right? So this kind of reporting they have been preparing. Top 5 customer based on the quantity they buy from all 4 quarters. And they also want to display graphically. At this moment, this is none of my business. We are more concerned about data, not the presentation. So we got top 5 customer, top 10 customer for last 4 quarters, and then we want to find out which customer is consistently